This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, oh yes, the one and only Nick Ravar from Avenue N and the Pantry joins us. Good morning, Nick.
Good morning, Mr. Kirby.
Always a pleasure to see you. By the way, you calling me Mr., I like it.
Okay. You can count on it.
It's always great to see you. Now, today we are making jalapeno chickpea fritters.
Chickpea fritters. And you know, I have done everything I can possibly do to drive this studio wild with food. I've cooked trays of bacon, seared pounds of burgers. I have never seen the place more abuzz about anything that I've ever done than these chickpea fritters right now.
You know what, Nick? If only you had a little more energy for this.
I said, no kidding.
You know, we'd really
no
appreciate that. So talk to us about the ingredients here. Looks fantastic.
Essentially, what we're going to make is like a play on a falafel.
Okay.
Okay?
I just love saying falafel.
I love saying falafel. You can spell it all different ways. So we've got chickpeas.
Okay.
All right. If you get them fresh, soak them overnight.
Okay.
Take them out. They'll almost be fully cooked at that point. Okay. It's like rehydrating it only.
Perfect.
These I'm using canned though. So open up, make sure they're fully drained.
Yeah.
When we puree that, we're going to puree it with a little bit of cumin, a little bit of garlic, a little bit of onion, jalapeno, all sorts of great flavors.
Awesome.
And then we're just going to lightly fry them in this grapeseed oil. It's going to be amazing.
I cannot wait.
So
my stomach is growling.
No,
already.
I know. I'm telling you, I've never seen it before. I'm going to make this killer yogurt sauce.
Awesome.
Lemon, curry, honey, all right, a touch of chive. And then this fresh, fresh salad of cherry tomato and celery is going to take center stage. Celery is, you know, celery plays the second fiddle.
It doesn't deserve it either.
Far too often. No, it doesn't deserve it.
Stepchild.
It needs to be right there in the limelight.
On display, and you are making it happen. You know, when I'm with you in the kitchen, I actually feel like I know what I'm doing. I don't, but when I'm with you,
listen,
I feel like
you're
I know.
Faking. You know exactly what you're doing. You got the skills, man, and this is going to be touched with a little bit of radish.
Beautiful.
A little bit of red wine vinaigrette. It's going to be fantastic.
Ah, like us.
And it's 50 plus degrees.
It's fantastic.
So
what
we're eating light.
Like
we're
this?
Eating light. We're living well. It's all good today.
Wonderful. Well, we'll check in with you in just a few moments. It's Chef Nick Ravar, ladies and gentlemen. He's the man. For now, back over to you. For now, back to two cool guys in the kitchen, Nick Ravar and Will Gilbert.
That is right. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Nick Ravar is here from Avenue N and not just Avenue N, the Pantry.
And the Pantry.
Which is right there.
Don't
Avenue
forget
N.
about the Pantry,
Don't forget
Will.
About the Pantry. You need the Pantry.
Listen, I've been working here.
Yes, you have.
All right. Things have changed dramatically since last
right.
you guys came to visit me here.
Uh-huh.
All right. I took that beautiful bowl of chickpeas.
Okay.
Canned.
Yes.
Drained.
Right.
Pureed now.
Okay.
All right. I
you.
Broke out the heavy artillery, the
okay.
food processor.
Nice.
All right. Boom. Pulse it. Now, also.
It's more of a.
Listen. So then I took the onions, the garlic, the jalapeno.
Right.
Very, very, very small dice.
Okay.
And then we went from. And we went to. All right. So we sauteed those. Folded them in. All right, folding them in.
Part of a kind of a requirement. You got
to
do sound effects when you do this. Yeah.
I feel like Jones from Police Academy here. Then I took a little cilantro. I took a little
parsley. 1980.
I took a little cumin. All right, and
yes.
we season these things up.
Okay.
All right, we season it up, and we came up with this beautiful mixture here.
It looks good.
All right, now
what do we got
to
do?
When you touch it, you don't want it to.
It looks like cookie
stuck.
Dough.
It feels like dough.
Yeah.
All right. So you don't. I added a touch of cornstarch to this. Cornstarch to keep it gluten free.
Okay.
Don't care about gluten free. Use flour.
Got it.
All right. Care about gluten free. Use cornstarch. There are certain brands that are gluten free. Make sure you look into that first.
Right.
So I'm going to form these and I'm going to put them into this grapeseed oil and fry them. All right.
Oh, okay. So while you're doing that.
Yes. I'm going to have you make a little yogurt sauce. Okay.
All right, so what do I?
So
need to
I've
do?
Got some Greek yogurt there.
Greek yogurt.
All right. I've got some freshly.
All right. So why the Greek yogurt? Is it because it's a little thicker?
It's the thickness. It's
uh-huh.
the flavor.
Right.
All right. It doesn't have anything really added to it. So it's sort of just pure yogurt.
Okay.
All right, we've got some lemon juice right next to that. You're going with all of that.
All of it in.
You're going to go with about half that curry powder. Now, curry powder is such a loud flavor. Use as much or as little as you want. That's good, Will.
Good, okay.
All right, and then you got some honey there. You can go with a little bit of honey, and I'm going to put in a touch of chive also. You're going to whisk that together, and this is going to be the sweetness, the sauce that's going to go with these beautiful fritters.
All right,
so again, we're calling them fritters. They're kind of like a falafel.
Right.
All right, and they're gorgeous. So you're going right.
to... So I'm gonna do this.
Yep.
You're going to drop those
I'm
in.
I'm going to drop them.
We got more to go.
We got more.
We're
going
to taste. We're going to eat. So we're going to do all that stuff.
It's
back to you.
It's all good stuff.
We are having fun on this Friday morning in the Rhode Show kitchen. Nick Raybar's here.
When are we not having
We're
fun?
We're always having
when
fun.
When are we not having fun?
Avenue N and the Pantry are the places that you can go in and see this guy and get some great food from him. The Pantry is a great place to go in. If you want to get something for dinner, you can
That's right.
Yeah, kind
and
of
grab
a grab and go option.
It's a grab and go. It's a great lunch spot. There's a lot of options there.
Yep.
This is something we're preparing for our new spring menu that's starting next week. These are chickpea and jalapeno fritters.
Good
Yum.
For you.
All right, good for you.
Good for you.
Good
too.
For you. So we're pan frying them, all right?
Okay.
About halfway up. Getting some nice brown color on it. We've got to make a salad here as well.
Okay.
So
yes.
I've got these beautiful cherry tomatoes.
Mm-hmm. Yum.
They look and now
good.
And now celery. You know, poor celery. It doesn't get its due credit.
I
right?
like celery.
And this is a celery-like salad. So
okay.
we're gonna put in a little bit of the small diced celery.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're gonna hit it up with some of these celery leaves also.
Now so you
we
were
save
soaking
them.
Yeah,
those.
We save them. Soak them. All right, because that makes them crisp.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that hydrates them beautifully, and it keeps them nice and... Otherwise, they get very wilty, especially in a hot kitchen.
That's something,
right.
too, that I'm sure I'm not alone. I chuck those.
I throw them
a lot of people chuck them. A lot of people, they have a ton of flavor.
Okay.
All right, throw in a little radish.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
Okay. So this is fresh as can be.
Yeah,
now I've got a touch of red wine vinegar. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Touch of salt. Touch of salt. Touch of honey. All right, let's just give it a second here, you guys.
Band,
so how's the weather today, huh, guys? All right, so beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Now, while that is marinating, we're going to flip these babies, all right?
And you had just dropped them
just
right before
dropped
we went
them.
On, so and they
see
really
how
don't
nice,
take long.
Nice and well, remember, it's chickpea, and it's already cooked.
Right.
So you're not really talking about cooking something here as much as you're talking about sort of
getting a little crispiness,
adding a little bit of texture to it.
Making sure that holds together.
Correct, correct. So a little bit of oil.
Okay.
And we're going to put in a touch of chive. And then we're good here, guys. We're going to assemble this.
Wow.
This beautiful, beautiful dish of the lightly pan-seared fritter.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And Michaela, if you'd grab me a spoon from in there.
You got it.
And Will, you made this beautiful, beautiful vinaigrette. Yes, you did.
Worked very
you
hard.
You sounded shocked
very
when
hard
I said
doing
that
this.
There. You sounded shocked.
I did?
Yes, you did. And it came out beautiful. So you see how fresh and vibrant and
mm-hmm.
spring everything that's going along with this is just perfect. So
it's a nice light meal, too.
It's a very, very light meal. So we're going to take a little bit of this gorgeous dressing.
And what went into that again?
This is a curried yogurt dressing. So curry, yogurt, honey, lemon. All right, put a little bit of that on the plate.
Mm. Very aromatic, too.
It is very aromatic. Curry is so strong. Curry is like, you know, a lot of people think curry is curry, and I'm one of these guys. Turns out curry is just a whole bunch of different stuff, like, mixed together. I thought curry, like, grew on a tree somewhere.
Oh.
Curry is like a mixture of all these crazy Indian-based spices.
I had no idea.
And it's so
new.
It
I
is
thought
so
curry was
flavorful.
Curry.
No, curry's not curry, Will. You see, we're learning a lot here today. So look at how beautiful and golden brown those are right there.
It's nice, too, to have that extra added crunch.
Oh, you've
like
gotta
you said,
have
you could have eaten this plain.
You can eat it plain.
Everything is cooked.
You can eat it plain. Everything is cooked. We're not cooking the raw fish here.
Mm-hmm.
We're not cooking a raw piece of meat that requires to being cooked to a safe temperature. All right, beautiful. Now
you can even make that mixture ahead of time, I'm sure.
Everything.
And then just drop them
refrigerated is ideal, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Then just some of this beautiful celery and tomato salad. And again, not something you might see every day, using those leaves, but the leaves have a ton of flavor. I use them on salads all the time at the restaurant. I've been using them for years. I've been using them for years, and finally they're getting the credit they deserve.
It's catching on.
It's catching on.
You're a trendsetter.
Yes, well,
cutting edge.
Took me about 14 years or so, but we got it. We got it there. And radish is totally in season.
Mm-hmm.
You'll see it at all your local farmers markets now.
Well, that's what's going to happen is that, all these cherry tomatoes are going to start popping up, these fresh
that's
produce
right.
that you're going to want to get your hands on because you're sick of eating, something frozen
right.
or something that's been brought in from
this winter
who knows
has been
where.
This winter has been brutal. It's been so long,
mm-hmm.
and now we're finally looking at some positive weather. And this is a great example of springtime.
It looks
right
good
there.
To me. But
yeah, it's absolutely beautiful.
It looks great.
It came out great. And again, we're working new menus over at Avenue N now.
Mm-hmm.
Give the address.
We have 20 Newman Avenue over in Rumford.
Got it.
It's a great spot, and we're doing great dishes like this and so much more. We don't take ourselves too seriously. We're just having fun. Like, come in here, we have a good time.
And the pantry is a great place, too. If you're looking for something to eat to bring home at nighttime, you can go in there and grab that, too.
You're 100% correct. You come in, you got to put up with my bad jokes. But besides that, everything else is just fine.
So you keep cooking good food. I don't care.
No, really, you're supposed to say, Nick, your jokes aren't that bad.
Nick, your jokes, but they're not that bad.
You can find great food like this at Avenue N and the Pantry, and you can find this recipe on WPRI.com.